Good morning. Welcome to Christ Church. I'm David Hall, one of the pastors here. We are so thankful that we can worship together here and down in the commons and at home. We have a lot of activities and events coming up during this Advent and Christmas season. We don't want you to miss a one of them, starting this weekend with the Tri-Octaves concert. So once again, here's the video showing these
events. Experience
an
abundant Christmas season with live music and worship at Christ Church.
It all begins the weekend of December 3rd with two shows by a group that puts the fun in fundraising, the Tri-Octaves. The upfront trio and backing band bring range in both vocals
hey, better watch out.
And style. It's like the three wise men of harmony follow the star to Motown, the Tri-Octaves.
Then, on Thursday the 9th and Friday the 10th, the Roche Chorale presents the annual Chattanooga Candlelight Service of Lessons and Carols. Hear the story of Jesus' birth through notable narrative and exquisite musical selections. Enjoy choir, orchestra, and congregational carols with Roche Chorale.
On Sunday, December 12th, all of our morning services will take place at the usual times, but you'll definitely want to return at 4 p.m. as the Christ Church Choir and Symphony members present One of Us. This special musical offering is now at a brand new time for our church family, our friends, and our community.
And nobody rings in the holidays like the Metropolitan Bells. This talented group will bring the jingle to Christ Church on December 16th at 7:30. It's uplifting. It's entertaining. It's the Metropolitan Bells.
Finally, during this busy time, make room for meaningful worship that will carry you through the winter, the Christmas Eve candlelight services. Both the sanctuary and commons will host varied observances in the afternoon and evening.
There is a reason for the season and so many ways for you and your family to find it. Experience Christmas at Christ Church.
You can get more information and know those dates and times by going to our website, to our Facebook page, and also the Christ Church app. We hope that you will register attendance this morning for those of you here in person. There's a blue attendance pad on the back of the seat closest to the aisle on each row. If you're sitting closest to that, if you would, reach up and take out the pad and register attendance, pass it along your row and then back again. For those of you worshiping at home, if you would, open the Christ Church app and register attendance so we know that you're there. This is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent is a season of four Sundays leading up to Christmas. It's a time for us to prepare for the coming of Christ. Today is the Sunday of peace. We have our first candle lit already. We're doing something a little different this year. Our children will do the reading for us.
We begin the Advent season today by lighting the candle of peace. One of the names which Jesus is known is the Prince of Peace. He gave his blessings to those who are peacemakers, saying they are the children of God. He promised his followers that he gives us peace that's more than anything we can imagine. It's beyond our understanding. As we start the Christmas journey, receive and share God's gift of peace.
Let's stand together as we sing our hymn of praise, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light.
I want to walk as a child of the light. I want to follow Jesus. God set the stars to give light to the world. The star of my life is Jesus. In him there is no darkness at all.
invite Josh and Liza Reifschneider to bring Emmeline and Genevieve for their baptism today. I saw Emmeline out in the hallway, and she was just so excited about this. And I thought, that's the way baptism should be for all of us. So glad that other family could be here. I know we've got other family, and we welcome you and glad you could be a part of this today. Listen again to words, language that we use to talk about baptism. Baptism is an outward and visible sign of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without price. Josh and Liza, on behalf of the whole church, I ask you these questions. Do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? And do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord? Finally, and most importantly for today, will you nurture Emmeline and Genevieve in Christ's holy church, that by your teaching and example, they may be guided to accept God's grace for themselves, to profess their faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? All right. Do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your commitment to Christ and your desire to serve Him as Lord? Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life, and include Emmeline and Genevieve now before you in your care? Let's join together. With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround Emmeline and Genevieve with a community of love and forgiveness that they may grow in their service to others. We will pray for them that they may be true disciples who walk in the way that leads to life. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and Emmeline and Genevieve who will receive it, to wash away their sin and clothe them in righteousness throughout their life, that dying and being raised with Christ, they may share in His final victory. Amen. All right, Emmeline. Emmeline Rose, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Genevieve Lissette, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right. She did well. All right. Friends of the household of faith, I commend to your love and care Emmeline and Genevieve, whom we this day recognize as members of the family of God and our sisters in Christ. Will you endeavor to live a life of faith and integrity and work to create a church culture of belief and service so that they may grow in the knowledge and love of God through our Savior Jesus Christ? With God's help, we will seek to order our lives and faith community after the example of Christ, that Emmeline and Genevieve, surrounded by steadfast love, may be established in the faith, confirmed and strengthened in the way that leads to life eternal. God bless you. God bless you. And Christy was here, by the way. Christy's been baptized previously. God bless you all.
Good morning. My name is Kara Stanifer, and I'm a member of the Sanctuary Choir. Our scripture reading this morning comes from the teachings of Jesus taken from two different gospel writers. First from John 14:27. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Then from Matthew 5:9, Jesus said, Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Come the long expected Jesus, born to set thy people free from our fears and sins. Release us, let us find our rest in thee. Israel's strength and consolation, hope of all the earth thou art, dear desire.
As we come to this time of offering here in our worship service, I would remind those of you who are in person that you have the opportunity to do your offering as you exit in the offering boxes just in the atrium. For those of you who are worshiping with us from home, now might be a good time to write your check or do your online giving as you so faithfully do. Would you bow with me now as we go to God in prayer? Gracious and holy God, as we bow in prayer to you today, we do so with a mixture of awe and humility. You are our Creator, and we feel small in your majestic presence, and yet you lift us with your love. Thank you for reaching out to form and deepen relationship with each one of us. On this week of Thanksgiving, we're mindful of so many things we have to be thankful for. Thank you for family gatherings that took place this week, of good food, of safe travel, and shared times. Thank you for the rights and freedoms we enjoy as a nation, and help us to share our liberty by lifting other people. Forgive us when we are arrogant or try to push our ways upon others. We pray for your continued presence with us as we cope with this pandemic that just does not seem to go away. We pray that our vaccines will be effective as new variants emerge. As we enter this season of Advent, we celebrate to see beautiful decorations and wreaths and chrismon trees, and we sing songs that remind us of the coming of your Son, the greatest gift ever. We pray that you bring your healing touch to those among us and in our families who are ill. Comfort those who have lost loved ones, knowing that our grief can be made worse around the holidays. Bless Nathan as he studies and listens for your word each week and then preaches the message you give him for us. And now would you join me here and in our homes as we pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
As Pastor David was just mentioning in his prayer, in our nation this week, we gathered and celebrated a day of Thanksgiving. And I want to take a moment here just to express my gratitude, how grateful I am for the many ways that you give of yourself as people of Christ Church, for the many ways that you give of yourself for the mission and cause of Jesus Christ in our world, for the ways that you serve the needs of other people, for the ways that you help other people come to know him in their life. I am so thankful to get to be in ministry alongside each of you. You are a generous people, and I've seen that happen again over the past few weeks. Just for another example, I encourage you to continue in that spirit of generosity as we finish out this year. Your financial offerings and gifts during December are going to be vital in helping us to continue many of our ministries into the coming year. December always seems to be a key month around here, so I simply ask that as you have been blessed, help us finish strong for this year. Today we do begin telling the story of Jesus again. In the church, we do that. We begin telling that story in this season of Advent. It's on what I call the Christian calendar. I mention that just to say that not only do we seek to do that in the church, tell the story of Jesus, but that each of us individually who seek to follow him, who seek to represent him in this world, that we're also called to tell his story by the way we live our lives, that other people come to know him and invite him into their life. The story does begin in the church with the season of Advent, that time of preparing for the coming of Christ into the world and into our lives. And of course, we annually do that by focusing on Christmas, Jesus coming into the world at Christmas. But I want to emphasize today that Advent is so much more than that. It is not just preparing for Christmas, but it is that understanding of preparing our lives all the time, in a sense of preparing to receive more and more of the Spirit of God into our lives every day, so that that Spirit guides us. And that Spirit, our Lord, constantly seeks to work through us in order to prepare other hearts, other lives, other people to know him as well. So, just like the other seasons of the year, we seek to let Advent remind us of how we're to live our lives every day of the year. In other words, we're to always be Christmas people. We're to always be Easter people. We're to always be Advent people. Each year, during our Advent worship services, we light these candles representing peace, hope, joy, and love. Well, during these four Sundays this year, I want to suggest that we look at those four as gifts that God gives each and every person through Jesus Christ. When we decide to follow him, when we sign on with him, if you will, when we seek to learn from him and learn how to live our lives from what he taught us, we receive these gifts. And they allow us to live life at its fullest, at its best. As we open each of those gifts this year on each Sunday and we examine them a little bit, you know how sometimes you open up a gift and you really start examining the details of it. We want to look at closely at each of these gifts. And as we do that, here's a primary point of celebration I want to suggest you think about. Not only do we get to keep the gift for ourselves, but we're also invited to give the gift away to as many people as we can. And here's the miracle in that. You get to keep giving the gift away does not diminish the amount of the gift that you get to keep. I mean, it's amazing how that works. You get to keep this gift, even as you seek to give it away as much as you can. And the thing about it is, it actually grows in you as you give it away. Isn't that amazing? It's a miracle. The first gift we open today is peace. We'll talk about the perfect gift. God couldn't have given us a more timely gift than the gift of peace right now, wouldn't you say? I know that this time of year we're all looking for that gift that'll just fit that person we want to give something to. Several years ago, my wife and I were welcoming our children home for Christmas, to celebrate Christmas, and particularly at that time we were getting ready to open our gifts that we'd gotten for each other. I noticed that our son, Matt, was grinning from ear to ear. He knew he had gotten the perfect gift for his mother. Several years ago, God saw her through a bout with ovarian cancer. And ever since she came through that, she's been on a mission to help women know of signs and symptoms and to realize that a lot of times there's not signs and symptoms and that you need to get tested for that. Well, the color for that cause is teal. Vicky also loves butterflies. So one day when Matt was out shopping, he came across this. And he knew he had the perfect gift for Mom. As you can imagine, she loved it. It hangs in a prominent place in our house. And I'm pretty sure that was one of Matt's favorite Christmases. Not because of what he got. He got some good stuff. But because of what he was able to give and how pleasing that was to his mother. God seeks to give to you and me and everybody else on the planet the gift of peace. The angels sang about it to the shepherds on the night that Jesus was born. Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace. God wants us to know, wants you to know an inner peace. But God also wants us to live in peace with others. And it's so important to have both of those understandings of what we mean by this gift of peace today. The Old Testament language of Hebrew has a word in it that really sums up and encompasses all that God is seeking for us here. It's the word shalom. And it's often translated peace, but it means so much more than just peace. It also includes things like harmony and wholeness, completeness, prosperity, and tranquility. And I would add that the teachings of Jesus, like love your neighbor as yourself and do unto others as you would have them do to you, that also is encompassed in the meaning, the full meaning of the word shalom. It is peace for each person, but also peace for the whole creation. It's like looking to the past in the Garden of Eden and looking to the future in our home in heaven. Last week, I mentioned a couple of lines out of the Lord's Prayer that we pray regularly together. I often pray these two lines this way: Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Last week, I emphasized that we as a people of Christ are not to just be looking for that kingdom out there in the future somewhere. It's not just about when Jesus comes back. It's about right now. That language and that prayer is present tense language, and we're to be looking and working for that kingdom in our lives even now. Today, I simply want to emphasize that this kingdom is a kingdom of peace. One of the names to be given to Messiah Jesus is the Prince of Peace. To be his people, therefore, is to be a people dedicated to peace. The verses that you heard read earlier, I pulled two verses from different gospel writers, two statements from Jesus, teachings of Jesus that he gave in totally different context, and yet I believe they are very much connected. First, from the gospel according to John, Jesus says to his disciples then and now, he offers them this gift of peace. I give you this gift of peace, not as the world gives, but I give you as I give in a different way. It's a different kind of peace. It is an inner peace that we can carry with us. And then from the gospel according to Matthew, his blessing on all who are peacemakers, saying that they are called children of God. In other words, to be the people of God is to be peacemakers. So here's a simple equation that I am asking us to focus on today. In order to be a peacemaker for God, you must first receive and know this gift of peace that Jesus offers. You see, my understanding of being the people of God means that we will be peacemakers. However, you won't be a peacemaker until you know the peace of Christ. So I want to offer two statements that kind of breaks that down, two shorter statements. Hopefully that'll help you to remember each one of them. Here's the first one. Seek peace in order to receive peace. Jesus said, ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. That certainly applies here. While Jesus offers this gift of peace to anybody and everybody, he doesn't force it on anyone. You can't force this. You can only offer it. Another prayer I pray almost every day is the prayer of St. Francis. It begins with this line, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. I was thinking about that this week, what it means to be an instrument. And I'm particularly thinking about what it means to be a musical instrument. To be a musical instrument means you have to stay in tune. You have to be tuned regularly. And to be, if you're not used very much, you get out of tune. And while you have to be in tune yourself, if you're going to be a peacemaker and play with everybody else, there's a certain amount of harmony you need to seek with others. You ever notice, you've probably noticed, that when an orchestra gets ready to play, what do? They tune with each other. Somebody plays a note, and then all the other instruments start seeking to play that note and making sure they're in tune with that person. Listen, they can only play beautiful music together when they're in tune with each other. That applies in life. We can only play beautiful music for our Creator as an act of worship for the one who created it all. We can only play that music when we're in tune with each other. There's an old prayer hymn that begins this way, Come, thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. If your heart is tuned by God to sing grace to other people, to share grace with other people, you will be a person of peace. The Apostle Paul began many of his letters, most all of his letters, to those Christians in the first century with this phrase, grace and peace to you. Now, he had particular reasons for putting those two words together. I would simply say for now, they really do go together. Grace and peace to you. Again, you have to constantly seek this gift. Psalm 34 has right in the middle of it this line, Seek peace and pursue it. The gift of peace that Jesus Christ offers is worth chasing after. It is to seek not just casually, but to chase after it, to run after it, to pursue it. And once you catch it, to hold on to it, to nurture it, to let it grow in your life. Stay tuned. As many of you have heard me encourage before, I say to everyone listening now, take time each day to be alone with the Holy Spirit, who is God, to seek this gift of peace. Why? Because every one of us go into situations every day. We have situations every day that stress us. You get stressed over various things. You have tension in your life. You have things that create anxiety in your life. We all need a higher power that gives us a sense of peace even in the midst of those situations. And so I encourage you, I beg you, I invite you to take that time, to spend that time alone with this Holy Spirit who is God, to pray with St. Francis, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Well, that leads to a second statement that goes with the second verse we heard read today. Share this gift. Be a peacemaker. Jesus said to do that means you'll be called a child of God. In other words, to be the people of God is to be peacemakers. Over in later in the Bible, in the back part of the Bible, there's the letter of James. In chapter 3 of that letter is this teaching. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Peacemakers who sow in peace reap a harvest of righteousness. They're always trying to do the right thing for by others. That's what it means to live in righteousness, is to seek to do the right thing, particularly by other people. That's why peacemakers are also involved in justice kind of issues. They're seeking to right the wrongs of this world. Jesus certainly did. Now, let me quickly add at that point that at one point he said, Jesus said, I did not come to bring peace. Well, now, wait a minute. What's going on? Why would he say that? He knew. He knew that there would be some who would not accept his way. He knew there would be some who would reject him, and therefore they would become disconnected from family and friends who did accept him, who do follow him. He would also challenge those powers in the world that abuse their power and they hurt people. Let's be clear here. His peace does not include an acceptance of the ways of the world. His peace does not include the injustices of the world, for he calls us to challenge those, to fight against those, to battle against those. It's not just about going along to get along, and I'm as guilty of that sometimes as anybody. I want to keep the peace, and so sometimes we just kind of go along and we accept things that we really shouldn't accept. Jesus is about peacemaking. That includes justice. As the protesters sometimes rightly shout, no justice, no peace. So our first gift from God today in this season of Advent is the gift of peace. Jesus Christ offers to you and me and everybody else this inner peace that we can carry, that will carry us through anything in life. He invites you to receive and nurture that gift. Let it grow in you all the time so that you become more and more a peacemaker, which means, according to Jesus, you'll be called a child of God. Receive and share the gift of peace. Let us pray. Gracious God, we are so thankful for this gift. You could not have picked out a better gift for us right now. Thank you for the gift of peace. Remind us, and thank you for this reminder today, to seek after it. That you're always offering, you're always waiting to share time with us each day, just in quiet, in solitude, in a spirit of peace. May we be more and more committed to that so that we more and more receive your peace in our lives and we can become peacemakers. We can carry your spirit of peace with us out into the world, out into those situations that stress us and stress the whole world. Teach us to receive and share your gift of peace. In Jesus' name. Well, there could not be a more of a theme song for peacemakers than the song the choir is about to share. Know that you're invited to begin or deepen a relationship with Jesus Christ. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the one who gives us this peace. And so maybe you're ready today to begin that relationship, or you know you need to work on deepening that relationship. Know that you're welcome to come either here as we close this service today or afterwards, or anytime. Contact us. Pastor David's contact information is there. He'd love to help you get connected here at Christ Church. Know that you're always welcome here. Let's hear this beautiful hymn, "Let There Be Peace on Earth." That really is our song. That really is our message on this first Sunday of Advent with this gift of peace. We know that we want to see peace in the world, but it's got to start with each of us. And in order for that to happen, we need to spend time with the one who gives the gift. Spend time with Jesus. Spend time with this Holy Spirit each day. Receive that gift and then take that gift with you out into the world. Go be the people of Christ. Go be a people of peace. Amen. God bless you as you go. Come again. Bring somebody with you.